So how do you shoot a cinematic travel video using just your phone? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can shoot something that looks like this. So everything you just saw was shot completely handheld using a phone. And in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how it was done. This video is part one, where I show you how to capture all of your shots. And in part two, we're going to dive into the editing and I'll show you how to edit all of these shots into a short cinematic sequence. A big thanks to Epidemic Sound for sponsoring this video. This is where I'll be going to get all of my music and sound effects for the final edit. Now let's head to our first location and start shooting some footage. Okay, so if you haven't guessed by now, I'm in London today, but of course you can shoot your travel video wherever you like. But what is really important is that you at least have some kind of plan. That way you're not just shooting countless hours worth of footage, because that's going to be a complete nightmare to edit. So to simplify today's shoot, we're going to be breaking it down into five simple steps. And step number five is really important, so do make sure you watch until the end. And tip number one is to celebrate your location. Okay, but what do I mean by celebrate your location? Well, I mean focus on things that make your location unique. Every place will have a different style, different character, landmarks that make it instantly recognizable. Take London, for example. We've got red double-decker buses, black cabs, Big Ben, red phone boxes. Everything about these details screams London. So let's capture shots that reflect all this so that the viewer knows exactly where we are. If I'm capturing a shot of Big Ben from Westminster Bridge, for example, I could just film a white truck in the foreground driving by like this. But this truck isn't particularly unique. So instead, if I just wait a few more seconds and capture the exact same shot again, only this time with a red double-decker bus in the foreground, we now have a much more unique shot. Now, if you were in Paris, you'd approach it in the exact same way. The Eiffel Tower, the cafe culture, boulangeries and patisseries.
By celebrating these elements, your film becomes a tribute to that place itself.
Also, think about anything else that adds a unique touch to your location. It's autumn here in London right now, so I'm going to take advantage of the seasonal colors by using these leaves as foreground for this shot of Big Ben. This will not only help make the shot look more unique, but also add another layer of interest. You'll notice I'm using foreground in a lot of these shots today. This is what will give your shots depth and is key to preventing your shots from looking flat and boring. Try to think about your shots in layers. Take this statue, for example. Not much depth to this shot. It's flat and boring. But if I simply move to the right and capture the same shot again, only this time with these trees in the background, we've now added depth and layers to this shot to make it much more interesting.
Now, it is a very overcast day today, which is creating a really nice, soft, diffuse light, but there's not a lot of color. Ideally, I'd like to see some light shining through these autumnal leaves, but this is England. We don't get a lot of sun, so I'm just going to embrace what we've got.
Okay, tip number two, camera movement. Camera movement is essential for adding energy to your shots. So here are a couple of easy techniques to try out on your next shoot. The first is to simply push forward. Take this shot of Tower Bridge, for example. Yeah, not great. Now, here's that exact same shot again, only this time pushing forward. Two hands on the phone for this. The more points of contact you have on the phone, the smoother your shot will be. And by simply pushing forward, we now have a much more professional looking shot. Here's another example. Only this time on the bridge. Here we have a static shot. Now let's capture the exact same shot again, only now pushing forward. Now, another technique for added camera movement is to follow the action. For this, choose a focal point. Fast-moving vehicles work well for this. Lock focus and exposure and follow the action, keeping your focal point in the center of frame. These shots are a great way of giving your travel films more pace and really help put your audience deep in the action. The opposite of this, of course, is not following the action and letting vehicles pass through the frame like this. Still a time and a place for this, but if you're looking to add more movement to your travel videos, follow the action. Now, if there aren't any vehicles at your location, then another great focal point for this technique is birds. Birds add energy and life to your shots.
The problem, however, is that birds are really difficult to film. In fact, out of everything that I've been shooting today, birds are by far the hardest, because you never really know where they're going to be, what direction they're going gonna fly. There's a lot of luck involved when it comes to filming birds.
I did, however, get lucky whilst I was next to Tower Bridge as somebody dropped their baguette and there was a bit of a feeding frenzy. Nice. Also, whilst we're on the subject of movement and adding life to your shots, then be sure to capture some shots of flags whilst you're on your travels. Flags are a great way of instantly letting your audience know where you are. Let me just show you what difference adding movement to your shots can make. Here is a shot at Buckingham Palace of the British flag with no wind. There is nothing more sad than a flag with no wind. This is about as lifeless as it gets, compared to, say, this shot here of a flag at the top of Westminster Palace with lots of wind, adding so much more life and movement. Flags are a great focal point to sprinkle into your travel films and also offer a great opportunity to add some sound design. Okay, tip number three, keep your clips short.
Now, as you saw from the opening sequence, none of those shots hold for long, just a couple of seconds. So you don't need to shoot long clips. Keep them short, 5-10 seconds max.
Short clips will keep the energy high, keep your audience engaged, and give you more variety to play with during the edit. A classic beginner mistake is to assume that you need long shots to fully capture a scene. But short clips actually make the final video more engaging because you're now capturing different angles and details of a location without it dragging on. Keeping your clips short also makes it easier to show the highlights of a place without overwhelming your audience. And when you go to the edit, you'll have more flexibility and can mix in different scenes quickly. Think of it this way. Each clip should feel like a snapshot of that experience, focusing on one key focal point. If you capture your trip in quick, memorable snippets, you'll end up with a final video that's not only professional, but also keeps your viewers excited from start to finish. So remember, quality over quantity.
Now, quick little bonus tip here for those of you that find yourself always running out of battery whilst you're on a shoot, and that is to invest in one of these. This is a portable power bank. Now, because I've got an iPhone and MagSafe, this one here magnetically connects to the back of the phone, so I can be shooting whilst charging my phone at the same time. And this will give me at least a couple more charges, because if you're out on a shoot, shooting video on your phone all day, it's gonna absolutely spank your battery. And having a portable power bank like this will avoid you having to go to a coffee shop and plugging your phone into a wall.
Okay, tip number four, creative transitions. Think of these as the secret sauce to a cinematic edit, but to make them work seamlessly, you'll need to think about transitions while you're filming, not just in the edit. So here are two simple but effective techniques. The first is to shoot your own unique transitions. These are great for sprinkling into your travel films. For this, I'm gonna go somewhere busy with lots going on. Piccadilly Circus will do nicely, and I'm simply gonna capture a shot quickly panning from left to right, right to left. You can also do this going up and down. And I'm gonna do this multiple times so that I capture a shot that looks like this. Yes, it looks like a complete mess, I know, but this is exactly what we're looking for, because we're gonna use small snippets of this shot to help us transition from one clip to another. For example, if we wanted to transition from this clip of Trafalgar Square, we could just use a simple straight cut like this. This is okay, not too bad, but now let's add our own unique transition between these two clips. We only need a split second, maybe 5 or 6 frames, and we now have this. These custom transitions are much more creative than any standard transition built into your editing software, so a great way of giving your travel films a more unique look as well as movement. Now, another technique is the whip pan. This is similar to following the action, only this time we're going to whip into the shot and then follow our subject or focal point. Bikes, cars, anything moving fast works for this. We can then use these shots to help transition from one shot to another. Also, this technique really lends itself well to adding sound design. For example, if we add a soft layer of music, a whoosh sound effect, and a bell, we now have this.
Now, I don't want to dive too deep into the editing side of things because we're going to save that for part two, but as you can see, as soon as you start to add music and sound effects to these clips, they really come to life. Now, if you're making a travel film, then by far one of the most important elements to help keep it engaging is music and sound effects. Because if you're shooting using your smartphone, then chances are your audio is probably going to sound pretty terrible. So having a professional archive of music and sound effects to delve into is massively going to help. And one of the best places for this is Epidemic Sound.
For example, let's say I've got 3 shots within a sequence, a flag, some birds, and a bus. Here is the original sound.
Yeah, not great. Now here are those exact same three shots again, only this time with music and sound effects.
Now, don't worry, in part two, we will be delving into exactly how to edit your shots to music and sound effects. But until then, at least start to think about what sounds will work well with your travel film. The beauty of Epidemic Sound is that they have a really good mix of professional sounding music. None of that cheap crap that can really kill the professional feel of your travel video. So whether this is a soft cinematic piano, a fast-paced orchestral piece, or a sound effect like a riser or whoosh, Epidemic Sound has everything you need. I've literally been using them for years. They are one of the best places to get music and sound effects for your videos. If you haven't given them a try yet, then make sure you do. I will put a link to a free 30-day trial in the description below. Okay, now moving on, tip number five, one of, if not, the most important tip yet, and that is people.
When shooting a travel video, make sure that there are people in your shots. Adding people into the frame adds that human element, making the film feel more real, relatable, and engaging. If you're traveling with a friend, then ask them to be in your video, or even better than that, find some locals and ask them to be in your travel film. I saw this old war veteran wearing a bright red jacket collecting for the poppy appeal whilst at Trafalgar Square, so I asked him to be in my video, and he said yes, just as long as I bought a poppy, which of course I did. For the sake of a small donation, I captured this great portrait of a legendary local for my travel film. I even got a salute. Now, do get used to rejection because not everybody will want to be in your travel film. I approached this police officer and asked him if I could capture some shots, and he respectfully declined.
I can't stop you. I would prefer if you didn't.
That's okay, no worries.
But persistence pays, because I spoke to these two police officers and they were more than happy to be included in my travel film. Also, you don't need to capture portraits like this. This is more of a stylized approach. Just make sure that people are in your shots. It adds personality. It makes the viewer feel like they're right there with you, experiencing the location firsthand. For example, take this shot here of the London Eye and red phone boxes. It looks okay, but lacks movement and life. So I'm gonna get my phone a little lower to the ground and wait for some bikes to pass, giving this shot much more life, energy, and movement.
Also, I can use that movement to creatively take my audience from one shot to another.
Take these shots here, for example. Most would assume that these are unusable and the shot is ruined, but we can use these people to our advantage, helping us transition from one clip to the next. Now, you could just keep things simple and use these wipes as a quick transition, or go a bit more advanced and mask around people for a much more creative approach. Either way, be sure to capture plenty of shots of people to help bring your travel films to life.
Okay, so with those five tips, you should be now ready to go out and shoot your own travel film using just your smartphone. In part two, I'm going to show you exactly how to edit all of those shots into a short cinematic sequence with music, sound design, and creative transitions. And if you're watching this in the future, you can find that video just here or linked in the description below. But that's it from me. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.